Alrighty, well, morning everybody, and back on again, and time for some Gems of War. And then, this time around, I think I forgot to put it, remember me to phrase that. I don't think I have the room in my Twitch description to put it down, but, sleep-wise, it was almost the opposite of yesterday. It sucked. I think I laid down at 11:30 last night, and then from then, all the way up until like 3 or 4 a.m., it was all dream and nightmare filled. It was like my subconscious decided to run a damn movie marathon. So it was one of those nights, around 3 or 4 a.m., I was forcibly awakened by my right hip. I've had this problem before. Basically, I slept wrong. Part of it might have been due to the dream and a nightmare that I've been having, body tensing up and all that. So my right hip was hurting like hell. So spent the rest of the time just hopping around trying to find a comfortable sleep position that didn't hurt. So by that time 6 a.m. rolled around, just said fuck it, rolled out of bed and got the stream going. So it's 6:40 a.m. right now. So yeah, a little bit earlier than the expected 7 a.m. that I normally start at. So basically what I'm getting at is don't be surprised if few hours in,
plop.
So, secondly, kind of like yesterday, I'm using my tablet for Twitch chat. Technically, it works, but there is gonna be a long, 30-plus second delay when, by the time you type your chat message down from farm to table, or from the time you type it to the time I receive it, it's probably going to be at least 30 seconds. So I'm hoping it improves over time, but we'll see. Oh, hey, screw. And then also, like usual, around this, normally when I'm streaming this early in the morning, I don't eat anything. Until then, it's just going to be water. Otherwise, for the session, dailies, faction assault, if I got time later on, assuming I'm still awake, probably just do some mat farming or something. We'll cross the bridge when we come to it. And then, got a new one. It's almost a good haul, for lack of a better phrase. Red Sun, Pillars of Sound. There's like this guitar part. There's this guitar part in the album. I'm a real sucker for it. So I've had a few other albums over the years that have that. It's like really cool. Figured it'd be worth a grab. And Morning Screw, in case I didn't say so already.
Oh shit, here we go again.
Yeah, faction assault. Game's gonna freeze up momentarily. needing imperial deeds. What I'm needing now are imperial deeds. I think I am. I'm at or close to 30 deeds on some of my other 30 deeds and some of my stuff. Struggling with English at the moment. I think like one or two. Okay. Well, there go all the greens. Been doing all right. Still working at Walmart. And now they're cutting hours. So. Yeah, this part. Oh, I guess I gotta. Slow it down a little bit for you. Just to give you an idea as to how the game works. Well, I kind of got lucky this month. My my property tax check came back, so I could weather the loss. The problem is the way they're cutting the hours. It's like they're completely redoing my schedule and giving me the same schedule as everybody else on my crew. Which I don't want. I mean, as far as cutting hours goes, it is what it is. But the problem is they're giving me the same schedule as everybody else, which I don't want. So basically, the whole goal of this game is you're the team on the left, and you have to defeat the team on the right. And you do that by, as is obvious, by matching gems. I still have to ask, but last I heard, the management at my store have nothing to do with the hour cutting. They're not the ones that do this. This came from the higher corporate office. From the higher ups. So even my management, they can't do anything. I'm stuck with what I got, but like I said, I'll probably ask, if only just to say, oh well, I tried. But anyway, and then making matches gives you gives you mana of that color, like what I'm about to do here. Yeah, this is gonna give me brown mana. And then if you look here in the upper left, like Luther here, he requires 11 mana. Gotten with either brown or blue. And once he gets 11 mana, you'll have charged him up and he'll be able to cast his ability. And then, normally, turn passes back and forth. But if you're able to get a 4-match or a 5-match, you'll get an extra turn. Okay, so is that full of mana? It's there's a sort of kind of PvP mode, but aside from that, it's single player. Here. He requires 4 red mana. And he's filled up and ready to go. Deal damage to the first enemy. Out she goes. And then these skulls here, if you manage to match them, the guy on the top here will deal damage equal to his attack rating. To the guy on the top over here. Oh, I need some purple. Yeah. Thrall here, he's this guy is classified as a mana generator. And then over here we got traits. Each card has one. 3 passive abilities here. Yeah. But yeah, as far as like actual direct head-to-head fighting, like say Street Fighter or, you know, like fighting games, no. It's pretty much single player. But like I was saying, this guy here, he's what's called a mana generator. His ability, destroy 39 gems. And if you look in the upper right, they're being removed from the board. And you're getting mana from each one. They all go. And then, goblins here, one of my favorite races in this game. Nearly all of them, whenever you use their ability, you gain an extra turn.
Oh shit, here we go again.
Hey Keith. So That's the basic nuts and bolts of this game. And then, your hero? Let me kind of rephrase that. This game also has classes, just like a lot of other RPGs out there. Take as long as you like. That's actually, it's one of my favorite things about this game. No pressure. In fact, you can have puzzle hints here turned on. Yep. Yeah, I don't think the last match. I don't think I myself had any four matches. My opponent was getting them all. Yep. If you sit and wait a few seconds, the game will actually give you a hint. Like in this case here, Warlord, I believe this is the very, very, very first class you get in the game. As you probably notice, there are a bunch of different troops. So you'll almost never get bored with this game. But I've been playing this game for, if I was to venture a guess, roughly 4 or 5 years now. So, I've accumulated quite a bit. And, there's also weapons in this game. Do it. Looks like I have to pick a team. There we go. And do I really want to see this? But banners give you a bonus to mana. To mana generation. I think that's the word I'm looking for. And then what you're probably interested in is, the classes. Like I said, there's many, many different types. Some you'll want to get more than others. Like Elementalist. That's the one class you'll definitely want to get to level 100. But, this here is also one of the real grindy parts of this game. Yep. But I think it's every battle you participate in, win or lose, I might be wrong, gives you one XP. Some content in here gives you 2 class XP. So yeah, the road to 100, it's gonna be a long and winding one. like what I said, some odd minutes ago, Drawl here is my mana generator. So when you're playing this, this is the guy you want to purple, or I should say in this case here, purple is the color you want to go for. They're the matches you want to go after first. So. Oh, another good thing about this game. Here, I'll just do this. You can use a controller and a mouse, and you can use both of them interchangeably. Not every game has this option. On some of them, you have to like go to the options menu, then you have to choose between a mouse or a keyboard. Not in this game. You can use them both back and forth. Yeah. I use a, in case you didn't notice, I use a PlayStation controller. So, you hold down L1, and then if you can see, the button markers, and then you hit X to cast. And then because there were 13 or more red gems on the board, I get an extra turn. And you can also, if you hold on R1, you can look at what your opponent has. Or, I should say, you can look at your opponents. Like, yeah, that's high priority target right here. And then I also forgot to mention too, when it comes to mana, if multiple characters share the same mana color, then the mana you get trickles down. Meaning the guy on the top gets first dibs on the mana. And if there's any excess mana left over, then the next guy on the next guy from the top gets it, and so on and so forth. And then again here, when you match skulls, your guy on the top here is gonna deal damage equal to his attack rating here to the guy on the top over here. Blade and Son of Zeus, maybe. Champion Pub, I gotta start winning fights in order to get a decent score on there, but. And, unlike other pinball tables, Kitaro, it's, if the ball goes in the outlanes, it will count as a fail. Most other tables that have a time mode, if the ball drains, no biggie. The mode you're working on still keeps going. So, yeah, Champion Pub's gonna be a problem. And then Jurassic Park, I don't know which one it is, but I'll have to pre-play that one. I won't be able to play it during the stream because of copyrighted music. Hey, got an extra turn.
Mana surge.
Yeah, he's getting them. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and set everything back to normal. So full speed. And as you can also tell here, I have a lot of teams. One of the best troops in the entire game right here. He starts battles with full mana. And extra green mana too. And then exploding, as it shows here, it'll blow up a random gem and then 8 gems around it, but you're only getting half mana from all those gems that you're exploding. I'm doing my dailies right now, Jay. Arguably the most powerful card in the game, Zul'Goth. Much for the perfect run. Yeah. So Che, what we're talking about, and yeah, this is the Soul Forge. You can make cards, you can make weapons, you can make currency as well. But what we're talking about here, to make this guy, you need 8 of these. And in order to make them, these orbs here, you get these by doing various events. And then souls here, yeah, you get souls by doing various dailies, various events. And defeating enemies. But in order to make a power orb, you need 3 of these, which are very rare. 3 of these, not as rare, but you're still not gonna find them that often. Same thing here. These are actually not as rare as the Major Orb of Ascension, but you're not gonna find it everywhere. They're not exactly gonna be dropping from the sky or anything like that. So, but like I said, I've been playing this game for probably 4 or 5 years, and I had only gotten Zolgoth maybe a few months ago. So, yeah, he takes an extremely long time to get. While I'm here, I gotta do this now, in case I forget later. doesn't want to make a payment now, but... Still looking. Oh, excuse me. Okay, another new one that I got yesterday. This is La Peste Macabre. Annus Pestilentia Morti. Spanish. What all I know about it. Pretty interesting album. yeah, Jay, in case you're curious. Yeah, this guy converts all skulls into what are called wild cards, which you can use for any match. And, any matches you do make, the mana you get is gonna be doubled. But ideally, you don't want to just cast it willy-nilly. You want to wait till the combination of skulls and gems results in at least a 4-match. That way, so it still stays your turn. Yeah. Bosom buddies. And then, I guess I could, now that I'm, while I'm at it, I guess I can kind of explain what some of the status effects do. Yeah. Like, if you're entangled, you'll deal 0 attack damage. If you're frozen, it can get pretty complicated, but, you won't get extra turns. Like, normally, when you get a 4 or 5 match, you'll get an extra turn, but if you're frozen, nope. Bad battle. And then, another status effect. Unless it shows it, which I don't think it's going to. But, is being stunned. As you can tell by the red slash here, what that means is all of your traits are locked out. Like, you have no access to them. And what I said earlier, it's going to be a bad battle. Like, possessed one here. Very valuable trait. Explode 2 random gems and 4 or 5 gem matches. It's gonna kind of slow me down right here, because now that he's stunned, I'm locked out of that. Centura gun? Kind of the same thing. whenever you match four or more gems, small chance of creating a wild card. Well, he was, up until recently, he was stunned, so. Especially when you have a guy like Zolgoth that requires 32 mana. See, you kinda need everything to work. So let me, And, sorry if this is information overload for you, Jay. And I'll show you another thing I like about this game. I'm on my notepad right now. And then, all these teams that you can make, you can take these team codes, and you can copy and paste them into your notepad. Let me see if I can show you. So, a wonky window might pop up here momentarily. I'll try to catch it. Like what I have here. Like I said, you can take all the teams that you have and you can copy them into your notepad. And when you need them, you can just paste them into the game. This ain't faction assault. This is my my last delve. Oh wait, this is No, still the same album. This part sounded kind of familiar. Actually, another album I have, Eagle the Blind Elf, Act 2, I think it is, has this very, very clip, so. Thank you. And then, yeah, this pops up from time to time, Che, but I'd probably say at least 90% of the time, I skip them. This is taken right off that other album I just mentioned. Wanting to do this now because I'll probably forget later. Otherwise, I'll forget later. Okay. Oh, and by the way, I haven't made it this far on this album. When I first heard this album last night, I just listened to maybe like the first 5 or so minutes. So, this is virgin territory for me. and for you guys as well, I imagine. Yeah. Squiddlies. I got a... One of the albums in my playlist is like... It's like this, like... Mephistopheles or something like that. And yeah, Che, this game also has pets. Pets give you a... They give you a passive buff, and you don't have to equip them or anything. But a lot of them will give you a lot of team bonuses. Like, if my whole entire team is from the Kingdom of Duragoth, then I'll get this buff. Yeah, that's, I actually kind of wish you were here. I'd say like a week or two ago when they were using the old cards. Because what you're looking at right now is a total fresh, brand new update. And these look pretty bad. I mean, they couldn't even fit the whole entire description in here, so they left off Beast. But basically, each card is from a kingdom, in this case here, Broken Spire. And then down here, it tells you what kind of cards they are. Like in this case here, he's an elemental and a beast. But again, they did a poor job on this, so that part got cut off. And they also have a... Tell you what level they are, obviously. And this is also their rarity. So just like cards in real life, these ones in here also have a rarity as well. Like, you got a full 6 stars here. So this is mythic. Rarest kind in the game. All the way down to common, and then kind of what you're looking at here, the light blue stars, this is their current rarity. This is kind of a measure of how powerful they are. The one with the little sparky thingy, that's their base rarity. That's what they started out at. Lower right corner, again, not a very good design choice, but this is how many traits they have unlocked. Which kind of ties into what I was talking about earlier. Let me see if I can find one. So like I said, a lot of these pets have this. Whenever you're running with a whole entire team that's from Cine Mirage, you'll get this bonus. In fact, since I'm here, one of my teams, the whole entire team is from the Nexus, so they're gonna get a triple team bonus. And even weapons have a kingdom of their own. So, and the class you choose also has a kingdom they come from as well. So, he's an elementalist. An elementalist class hails from Nexus. The weapon is also from Nexus. King Heliodor here, same thing. Same thing, so the whole entire team is from the Nexus. They get a stat bonus because they're all from the same kingdom. Same thing here. Stat bonus here, stat bonus here. And yeah, what you saw there, that little pop-up, that is one of the drawbacks this game has. It'll pop up microtransaction offers to you, which gets annoying. So, what I'm doing now is the Underspire event. It's kind of a callback to the old Dungeons and Dragons, you know, graph paper dungeons, you know, the kind you drew on graph paper. Underspire is kind of, so like I said, Underspire is kind of a throwback to that. Silence. One of the best debuffs in this game. When you silence somebody, they can't cast spells, and they can't gain mana. So, kind of a 2-for-1. Thank you. Oh, damn. Because I have a shit memory, I gotta look at something real quick. And then this third new one, it's kind of a throwback to the old 60s, 70s Moog synthesizer music. It's some cool stuff, but it's like very repetitious. It's like a 30-minute album over three tracks. So yeah, I might be, so chances are, when one gets too repetitious, I might skip over to the next one. He tries to switch it up, but it doesn't really help that much. lucky. Like using a sledgehammer to kill a mosquito. Oh, damn.
Huh?
Still in the lead. Every day, but apparently not. I mean, it's every other day. I guess we're doing faction assault. Let me, just... Zolga and Aura, what? Aura, Centurion. Get this? Exploding up to 12 gems. Oh, this is gonna be hard to read. Green, was he? wasn't green. Wild green team. Leprechaun? Yeah. Well, I was able to get the damn thing. All possessed. God, it's so hard to read. Thank you. War match. Merge, Joe. Oh, and I did forget to mention at the start of the stream, there might be some background noise going on outside. I got the patio window open. Okay. Too much of a good thing. Alright, and I do need to fix the album art in this one. And this is a genre of techno called Gabberna. Not. Yep. But yeah, for those who don't know, Angerfoot, it's just a series of first-person shooter games. Or one of your biggest weapons is your foot. I'm guessing they're cutting grass outside. In case I didn't say earlier, this is a subgenre of techno called Gabber. Kicked cutting grass. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and break off for a few, and then this is also gonna be where some technical issues might rear their ugly heads. My tablet is at like 20% charge right now, so I gotta get that back on the charger, and I'm gonna have to replace it with my cell phone, which for those that don't know. It has Wi-Fi reception issues, and I'm gonna shut the patio window real quick. I'm tired of having to talk over that thing. So yeah, anyway, So yeah, my cell phone's got like Wi-Fi reception issues. So there may come a point where I won't be able to read the chat in real time. Like I have to actually go on my browser and read the chat on there. So, but anyway, let me go ahead and throw this on. Better loop it. Whoa!
Pick a sage. Go for some solitaire.
Yeah. I'm trying to do it before 480p. I'll be back.
One. Go! Three, two, one, go! results. Can you handle playing the next stage? Congratulations! Now do your best on the next stage.
I made it today, but tomorrow... Ouch!
Don't worry. Just do your best. That's all you can do.
Pick a stage! Three, two, one, go!
So, is this an arcade game?
Ouch.
Okay.
Ouch.
Ouch. Yeah. Remember if it was arcade or console, but there was another one called Pilot Wings. Star Fox was a Super Nintendo. I think it was on other platforms as well. I want to say there was also some 80s arcade games that had something Thunder. I don't remember. Oh, hey Scout, something Thunder. You flew around a helicopter and you flew over cities and you like shot stuff. Thank you. I'll do it again. Three matches.
Holy shit.
Nice to see I'm not the only one that has to go through this shit.
Thank you.
nails and kicked in. No, 36, never mind. Hey, 40% kicked in. much. Nope. Submerged. What else I can do? Hey, 40% kicked in.
once again. Good. On it goes. I need some green gems. Much to work with. Almost, but not quite. Okay. Off to the next one. And this is Snakes Don't Belong in Alaska, Sounds of a Forming Planet. submerged. It's now noticed. Not a poor match, huh? This area is designed, you're pretty much just a one-way street anyway.
the story about the beginning. Some 15 billion years ago, our universe began. The mightiest explosion of all time. The universe expanded, cooled, and darkened. Energy condensed into matter mostly hydrogen atoms. And these atoms accumulated into vast clouds, rushing away from each other, that would one day become the galaxies. Stars was born, kindling the energy hidden in matter, flooding the cosmos with light. Hydrogen atoms had made suns and starlight. There were in those times no planets to receive the light, no living creatures to admire the radiance of the heavens. But deep in the stellar furnaces, nuclear fusion was creating the heavier atoms, carbon and oxygen, silicon and iron.
As much as I like Carl Sagan, I've got a very hard time watching his show. I kind of have the... He kind of has the same effect that Teletubbies has on me. I sit there and watch just... Like, yeah, that's it, just... Most wonderful viewing experience, and it looks like this. It looks like this year is starting to turn to shit as well. Didn't get my surge. not a poor match, huh?
Thank you.
nice to have had. This one's nice to have had at the start of the battle. Mouse is double tapping. I could do some of these. Oh, damn, I got like four of them. Still not enough. He's gone. Oh, stuck around. Hey, not once but twice. Diamond. Wow, three in a row. GG. kind of nice to have some orbs of ascension out of all this. Cedric. Cedric. Kind of great to be able to keep this going, though. There! Fucking finally! Matches. We'll be right back. browns and yellows. Still can't get my damn surge. Yeah, it's pretty damn bad when the queen goes up before the tooth does. Still not enough. Okay, so, but yeah, that's gonna go ahead, or that's gonna do it for me, everybody. I'm just gonna go ahead and call it good. Had a good stopping point anyway, so, yeah. Need to get going on my stream video. Gotta get that all set up and prepped up and exported to YouTube. Still need to do my blog post as well. And definitely gonna need to get a nap in there too. And then normally I stream pinball, but as my tablet is down to 20% and it's currently charging, and I don't really trust my cell phone right now to continue working without messing up. So unless something major changes, like my tablet is charged up to 100% and it gets up and running fairly quickly, the way it's looking right now, I'm probably just gonna do probably not gonna be a stream. I'm probably just gonna do like the FX3 matchups, post the results up on the YouTube community post, and then I'll probably just do like I'll record and upload a short pinball arcade session, possibly Zachariah as well. So that's currently what I have going right now on the agenda. But again, unless my tablet gets up to speed like quick, like, you know, before noon when I normally try to do a second stream, then yeah. So, but otherwise, hey, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. I appreciate that. And if you don't see me later on, and I'm guessing that's what's gonna happen, then I should be on again tomorrow morning. My default time is 7 a.m. and that is U.S. Central Time. So, until then, thanks again for coming by, everybody, and I'll see you all next time.